SOMED, Cervical Cancer Prevention Awareness and Health Matters. Your partner in health matters. Dedicated to promoting awareness of both male and female issues.
This video does not provide medical advice as it is intended for awareness and information purposes only. This video is for adults and parental guidance only. This video is not a substitute for professional advice, diagnosis, and treatment. Please do not ignore your professional medical advice because of what you are going to hear in this video. Should you have any medical emergency, please contact your doctor or emergency services.
Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Edna Dapper and I spoke about normal vagina bleeding in my previous video. Today I will be analyzing why abnormal vagina bleeding occurs. It is important to bring abnormal vagina bleeding process to lamplight and create awareness of it since the condition is experienced by the vast majority of women. Please join me on another knowledge-impacting discussion that will enable women to understand the reasons for certain occurrences in the system. Abnormal vagina bleeding is quite familiar to most women and could be expressed as a symptom of a benign process or as a sign of a disturbing condition. It is referred to as any vaginal bleeding that is not related to the normal menstruation process. It is vaginal bleeding between periods or intermenstrual bleeding. Such bleedings could relate to issues with the reproductive system or to other medical problems or certain medications. Abnormal vaginal bleeding, as the name implies, does not really mean bad news all the time. There is a wide spectrum of reasons for abnormal bleeding that ranges from a situation of no medical concern to a rather very disturbing condition. Some causes of abnormal vaginal bleeding may be easy to treat, whilst others could indicate a serious underlying problem. This bleeding is an extremely common symptom that is experienced by most women at some point in their lives. Most of the time, a benign process causes bleeding or spotting, and hormonal fluctuations are often the culprit. Today, I will be talking about two processes that could cause abnormal bleeding. These are birth control and ovulation bleeding. Abnormal bleeding may include spotting of small amounts of blood between periods as seen on toilet tissue after wiping and panty liners, or extremely heavy bleedings in which a pad or tampon is soaked for hours. There is a difference between spotting and bleeding. During spotting, the quantity of blood discharge is scanty, whilst it is significant in bleeding. Also, the causes of spotting are different from those responsible for bleeding. It is recommended to seek medical attention if any bleeding or spotting between periods is experienced. One factor that could cause abnormal vaginal bleeding is birth control, also known as contraception and fertility control. This is the use of any practices or methods or devices to prevent pregnancy from occurring in a sexually active woman. Birth control has been used since ancient times, but effective and safe methods of birth control only became available in the 20th century. Birth control methods are designed to prevent pregnancy in different ways. The barrier method of birth control prevents sperm cells from meeting an egg. The hormonal birth control method functions by preventing ovulation, so a woman is temporarily infertile. The barrier methods of birth control are techniques that use physical devices such as condoms to block the passage of sperm cells from entering the uterus or by destroying the sperm cells using spermicide, thereby preventing pregnancy. Sterilization method is also a barrier technique that is considered as a permanent method of contraception, but may be reversible in some cases. It is a procedure that blocks the fallopian tubes, preventing the meeting of eggs and sperm cells. Vasectomy is the option in men where sterilization takes place during the sperm cells are blocked. Fertility awareness method of farms is a barrier approach, also called natural family planning, and are behaviors to track ovulation to prevent pregnancy. The days near ovulation are the fertile days when pregnancy is most likely to occur. So avoiding sex or using another birth control method like condoms on those unsafe or fertile days to avoid contraception. Hormonal birth control methods involve the use of hormones on a regular basis, and this is one of the most effective methods of contraception. This method includes implants, intrauterine device, IUD, injections, pills, and skin patch. The pill is the most common method of hormonal contraception, and it is taken daily. Most birth control pills contain a combination of estrogen and progesterone hormones. Hormonal pills function by stopping ovulation from occurring. The pills also change the consistency of cervical mucus, thereby inhibiting the transport of sperm. The pill also makes the uterine lining hostile to implantation. There are side effects of birth control pills, and this could be breakthrough bleeding, BTB, or spotting, which is a common side effect of birth control pills. BTB may also happen after a switch to a different type of contraception or to a pill with a different estrogen dose. Many of the newer generations of lower hormone birth control pills have little or no estrogen, and this tends to have fewer side effects. However, the super low estrogen hormone doses makes breakthrough bleeding more likely. The IUD is inserted by a medical doctor into the uterus and prevents pregnancy. It provides long-term birth control for 3 to 10 years, depending on the type of IUD. It is normal to experience some spotting or bleeding after IUD insertion. With a copper IUD, irregular bleeding is relatively common and can go on for quite a while. An IUD can sometimes become displaced, and when this happens, some bleeding after sex may be experienced. If BTB or spotting does not go away after about 6 months, it is advisable to consult a medical practitioner to exclude anything sinister. The second process that could cause a woman to experience abnormal vaginal bleeding is ovulation. This is a process that happens once in every menstrual cycle, during which a matured egg is released from the ovary. There is a swift drop in estrogen level after the release of egg, which destabilizes the endometrium and causes uterine lining to break down, resulting in slight bleeding. This is known as ovulation bleeding that some women may observe prior to a menstruation. Ovulation bleeding is relatively common and usually harmless. It could present like a few drops of blood and can show up for about 1 to 2 days. The blood is often mixed with cervical fluid and could appear light pink or red in color. Abnormal vaginal bleeding has been discussed in this video, and we can see that normal processes could also be responsible for bleeding or spotting between the menstrual process. The birth control pill is the main culprit that is known to cause this condition. If abnormal bleeding is experienced, please carry out self-investigation, and if there is concern, consult your medical practitioner without hesitation. I hope to see you next time, when I will continue the discussion on more causes of abnormal vaginal bleeding. Thanks for watching, and please like and share this video to your friends and family. And I will see you soon.